Hi everyone. I just thought I would make a video and show you my hobby. I took up rock painting last year. This was my rock I found at my work. When you find a rock, you're supposed to take a picture, post a picture in the group written on the back. And the name of this group was MCR/MC Rocks. And then the person that painted it will speak up, and if they don't, even if they do, you're supposed to rehide it for somebody else to find. You don't have to be good at it, and trust me, I'm not good. And this one I found out by our mailbox, and I don't know what CV59 means. I looked in some groups for initials of CV and I didn't find any. But you're supposed to post a picture and rehide them, and I'll rehide them at some point. But anyway, this is the first rock I made. And I didn't copy it. It's supposed to be trees on each side of a stream, on some land with flowers. And there's all kinds of supplies that you can use or not use. There's paint and markers. There's certain sprays. And I used the wrong spray and it all blurred. I could have redone it. The good thing about painting rocks is they're forgiving and you just paint over them and redo them. But that was my first one and I didn't want to redo it. I just left it. But that's my second one. And there's a lady named Ann Webster. She's in a group called Heart Rocks. And she paints rocks live a couple times a week. And I watch her, and then I replay the video and paint along with her. And you can pause it and then paint and pause it and paint. And that was my first one, and I must have redone this about 4 times. And it took me weeks because I thought they had to be perfect, and they don't. And this is far from perfect, but I was just nervous because it was actually my first one that I did from any of the groups, and I was nervous. I wanted it to be good. That's supposed to be our little poodle. She did a different dog or her dog or whatever, and I put our dog on there. And this one I copied from Ann Webster too in Heart Rocks. So that was my second one. This one I copied from a picture. It was a field of flowers or whatever. I kind of like that rock. I thought it was a mess and my husband liked it, and he makes me all these frames, but he didn't make this one. This one I had. So this was in my next bunch. That one, the lower left, was supposed to be my friend and I. I copied it from another rock, but I just added my own touches and different color clothes, and that was really fun to do. And that's just a Valentine rock I copied. And I love this tree. It's one of my favorite ones I did. And it was really fun to do. And it looks really hard, but it actually didn't take long at all, to where some of these can take me weeks. And here's another one. My husband makes me these frames. And he made this one to hold 4. But there's that little girl holding an umbrella. I copied that from another rock and another group. This one I copied and added my own touches. The girl holding the signs with, you know, the race cars back there, old cars, whatever. And that silhouette was in a group. I think that was in Ann Webster's group called Heart Rocks too. But that was fun to do. They were all fun. And that's just a hippie van with the car. This car is actually, in the picture, was actually painted on the van, not sitting next to it. So that was fun to do. Oh, and this was one of the first ones. So this one should be back there somewhere. That's supposed to be a little poodle. Just shows that you don't have to be good. You learn as you go. And this is just one I played with. I painted glitter paint on it. Just playing. And these hat ladies are fun to do. That took me a while, but it was fun. And if you mess up, you just paint over it and fix it. Sometimes you want to throw them. And I've thrown them before. Or I get mad and I'll just smear paint on them. But you get over it and you start again. This is fun to do. Some of them that look the hardest or the easiest, And sometimes they're the most fun. This was fun to do. I must have restarted this 5 times. I got her legs too fat, but I got tired of redoing it, so I left it. But it was fun. And it's a fun holiday rock. Well, it's supposed to be anyway. He's holding carrying a Christmas tree on the back of the truck. That was fun. This was fun too. They're all fun. The lady with the umbrella, hat lady. That little monkey was fun. I remember I found him on Pinterest. And this was just a practice rock. I started with that little tree thing. And I just put a bicycle there to see if I could paint a bike. And then I saw another picture of a lady on a bike. So I put her there. And then I was doing a different rock with the child sitting on a tricycle. But I couldn't get this right. And then I couldn't get the seat right. And I wanted to put the child on it, but I was afraid of messing it up worse. So I just put her there like she's going towards the bike or whatever. It's just a practice rock. You can do anything you want. And this is a lady blowing bubbles. I first saw her on a different rock, and she was holding a sign, something to do with witchcraft. And I had her face, and I thought, I don't want to do that. What can I do with that face? So I found a picture of a hand, and I put her hand there, and that's supposed to be a wand, and she's blowing bubbles. Bubbles are fun. When you look at them farther away, they look like they must be hard, but they're not. This is just a silly one I did of a, I don't know, alligator, crocodile, whatever. But he was fun. And this one, my sister who passed away loved sunflowers. And I still want to do a rock with sunflowers with, you know, and try and put around it. Because she had purple hair and she was fun and silly. And that's supposed to be a lady smelling of a sunflower, but I don't know. And I didn't, you can paint the back white or whatever. And I might, it's not finished. I just didn't want to mess it up any worse. But I might put sunflowers somewhere around and then make like a field of sunflowers in the back. And this is another sunflower. This one inverted. I used my computer and just turned it around. And you can see it don't look the same. They don't have to look the same. But this isn't done, and I don't know. I have to figure out how to turn her around to face her this way and then figure out what I'm going to do. But see how this goes to the back? I need to finish the background, and then I can paint something on the back, more flowers, whatever. And this, I was just fooling around, trying to copy a flower I saw on Facebook in one of the groups. It looks really bad, and I was just gonna forget it and paint over it and redo it. And then you calm down the next day and you look at it again and you think, oh, I can do something with that. This brown is just part of the background, and then you paint greenery over it. And there again is the two I found. And this is actually a piece of concrete where at my work where they were digging up concrete. You can paint anything, you know, wood or anything. And so my husband filled it in with this stuff. That stuff. And then he smooths them off with this, because there's one that he's filling in right now. It's a piece of concrete. And then it'll be smooth like the other one, and then I can do something with that. And there's some other rocks that I'll do something with. But that's what this was, and now I just have to paint over this and, you know, to smooth it out. I actually had all these rocks on top of the refrigerator, and somehow I jarred. I forgot they were up there, and I went to move that cabinet, and they all fell, and some went behind it, so we had to dig them all out. And so my husband knows which rocks goes on which stands. So some of these go on different stands. He knows, but he isn't home, and so I have to let him figure that out. But anyway, one other thing I want to show you is there's rocks called Santorini rocks. I think they're from Greece. I won these on Facebook in a group, and I don't know which group. But they're beautiful, beautiful rocks. These haven't been painted. That's the natural color. I'm trying to hold them so you can see how they sparkle. They're just, oh, sparkly. They're beautiful. They're too beautiful to paint. And so that's why I haven't painted them, because I want to get a lot better than I am at it. But anybody can do this. You don't have to be good, like I'm not good. It's just fun. You start out with junk like that, and then, like my husband said, you get better as you go. But you know what? I didn't do this all summer long because there was so much stress with all this COVID stuff, and you know, then being off work and then going back to work. And so the other day was when I started this, and you can see what a mess that is. And I thought, oh, it's been too long. I wish my phone had a pause button, but it doesn't. So I'm going to take you in the other room. I'm in the room where our birds play. There's their stand. It's also my toy making room. So anyway, I'm taking you out here. I want to show you my cabinet where I keep my paints. I might as well show you. There's Mosey Mosey. Yeah, I'm Mosey Mosey. There's Zaz Rooney. Hi, Zaz. Hi, Zaz. I love you. And there's Ethel May. Yeah. I'm a naughty girl, but I'm sweet. So anyway, here is my cabinet where I keep my paints. I got this from Walmart. It's a shaky thing. I can't really roll it. I mean, I could, but everything would be a bigger mess than it is. And every drawer, them have to lay down because they're big. But they're more like on sale at Walmart. But you just store your paints. I should have straightened all this up, but I didn't plan this. But I keep all the paints. See, it comes off the track. But all these drawers got paints in them. And brushes and all kinds of stuff and markers. But anyway, that's what I keep them in. It's a lot of fun. It's a hobby. It's something to do. And anyway, I just thought I would show you that and share that. So maybe somebody can start a new hobby by learning this. And then when you're painting, I use this lid. This goes to like a big coffee can, and you set your rock on here. And you saw them silly putty eggs in that drawer. You take silly putty and you put it on here and put your rock on it, and it holds it in place, you know, as you're painting and stuff. It's a lot of fun. I sit right here in my chair and paint. But like I said, I didn't do it all summer because of all this going on. And now I know, oh, I should have been painting. So anyway, one last look at my critters. What? There's Ethel back there. She's a Timney African Grey. Zaz is a Congo African Grey. And there's Mose. Mose, can you wave? Can you wave? Hi, wave, wave. Can you wave? Okay, do it, wave. Hi. Come on, he's gotta stretch first. Mose, can you wave? I think I have another video where he waves. He's not gonna do it. All right, I hope you enjoy this. I hope somebody can take up painting. I don't know, I might not even post it. I have to rewatch it and see how it looks. Have a good day. Gonna wave? Gonna wave? Can you wave? Okay, bye.